morning to everyone.
大家早上好。
And to our pastors, thank you so much for giving me the opportunity to share.
我也首先要谢谢牧师给我这样的一个机会来分享我的见证。
I am Shani, as I was introduced before.
我就是陈秋璇了。
And I'm from Phoebe's cell group.
我的组长是 Phoebe。
And so today I just, oh yeah, I want to wish everybody a very happy Chinese New Year.
我先跟大家说，大家新年快乐。
And so with that, I just think back to all that has happened last year.
当我回想起去年所发生的一切。
And I just feel like it was truly a very, very eventful year.
发现到去年是一个对我来说是经历到很多事情的一年。
And you know, it was the first time that I had been overseas, the first time I left home.
去年是我第一次离开家，出到国外。
And I went to Melbourne.
我去到墨尔本。
To finish my studies in pharmacy.
来读那个药剂的课程。
It was a very scary experience.
对我来说是一个蛮可怕的经验。
To leave home for the first time.
因为第一次要离开家那么久。
And you know, there's no family there. There's no mom washing your clothes. There's nobody cooking for you.
在墨尔本又离开家，没有家人，妈妈又没有跟我一起去帮我洗洗衣、煮饭给我吃。
Even though that's not what mothers are for.
就即使妈妈本来的任务不是这样子啦。
It's just, you know, you miss the times when there's somebody doing things for you.
但是你去到国外一个人的时候，你就会想到有人帮你做这些事情。
And suddenly you're just all alone.
突然间你会感觉孤单一个人。
And I was learning to use how to go to the bank, you know what a bank is.
所以我就开始如何的去到银行，要认识银行到底是怎样的机构。
You know how to put money inside.
如何的存款。
How to take money out.
如何的拿钱。
You know, very skillful things.
发现这也是很需要技巧的事。
And I think if it wasn't for God's guidance throughout the whole year,
我相信如果不是去年整年神的带领之下呢，
I would have had a very different experience in Melbourne.
我会觉得我在墨尔本会有一个更糟糕的经历。
And I was over there trying to adapt to the environment and trying to have a, because pharmacy is a very, very busy schedule.
因为药剂课程是其实是很学业上很繁忙的，然后我需要又要同时间适应当地的环境。
And so I just want to thank God for everything that He has brought me through throughout this time.
所以真的要感谢神，神如何的带领我经历这一切。
And there was one, I suppose, highlight of the year.
在去年有一件事情让我值得很感恩的是。
And that was that last August, I came back to Malaysia for my break.
去年八月我就因为学校假期我就回来马来西亚。
And towards the end of my break, on the day I was flying back to Melbourne,
正我要假期结束，正我要回到墨尔本的时候的那一天呢，
I suddenly experienced this pain in my abdomen.
我发现我腹部上半部其实开始有疼痛。
And this pain didn't stop. It was just continuous for 6 hours.
这个疼痛持续了六个小时。
And I thought, okay, maybe it was food poisoning.
我就想哦，可能是食物中毒。
Because Malaysia has awesome food, so all you do is just eat and eat and eat and eat when you come here.
因为马来西亚有太多好吃的食物，所以来到回到马来西亚就是不断的吃啊吃啊吃。
And so I thought, okay, maybe I have food poisoning. I was vomiting. I had diarrhea the whole day.
所以我就觉得可能是食物中毒，我又上吐下泻。
And but slowly, just sort of, the pain just wouldn't stop, and it was really, really painful.
但是慢慢的那个疼痛越来越严重，开始我感觉到非常的痛了。
And so I went to the hospital.
我就去到医院。
And they told me I have appendicitis.
他们告诉我我有得了盲肠炎。
I was really shocked.
我就开始我很震惊。
Because you know your mom tells you, you know, don't jump around.
因为你记得妈妈每次说吃饱饭后不要乱跑乱跳。
Because if you jump around, you're gonna get, you know, food in your appendix.
然后你乱跑乱跳的话，食物就进到你的盲肠里面。
And then you're gonna end up in hospital.
然后你就要进医院哦。
But you know, I'm a really good girl. I was pretty sure I wasn't jumping around.
但是我是一个很乖的孩子，我确定我吃饱过后都没有乱跑乱跳。
Well, either way, I had appendicitis.
但是无论怎样，最后我还是得了这个盲肠炎。
And on the day of my flight,
所以就也这件事情发生在我要上飞机的那一天。
I had to go through an operation for the first time in my life.
我就第一次要经历动手术。
And people tell me that appendicitis is a minor surgery. Don't worry.
很多人跟我讲，割盲肠罢了，小问题，不是很大，不是大手术来的。
But I found myself just worrying and worrying and worrying.
但是我发现我其实一直都很担心，很焦虑。
And I was imagining all the operation theater with all the lights on you and those cold metal tables.
我就可以想象到我躺在那个手术台上，有很多的仪器，有很多的灯光，有很多的人在看着我。
And I thought, you know, what if the anesthetic, you know, when they put it in you, then, and you don't wake up?
我就会幻想想很多的，如果那个麻醉打了下去，然后我一打就永远不醒呢？
Or what if, you know, what's even worse is if I'm awake and I can feel everything, but nobody knows.
然后更糟糕的是，那个麻醉打了下去，我没有被麻醉，我可以经历所有的一切，但是没有人知道我其实是醒着的。
So I was, it was just worries and everything just going through my head.
所以在进手术之前，我就想了很多的状况。
And then I just told myself, you know, no, you have to stop, and let's just calm down, and let's just pray.
然后我就告诉我自己，我必须要停止这些的幻想，我需要冷静下来，开始祷告。
And so, praise God, it was a successful operation.
所以我感谢神，手术成功。
And I had to miss 3 to 4 weeks of my classes.
当然，我就要缺课了3到4个星期的课。
And it just felt really crazy because.In Melbourne, when I was doing my pharmacy course, I barely even missed classes. That's how tight the schedules were.
在墨尔本的时候，当我上课，我几乎是根本没有缺席过任何一堂课。
And so to miss 3 to 4 weeks of classes, I felt like, well, this is the end of the world.
所以对我来说，缺课3到4个星期，对我来说是一个世界末日的状况了。
I felt like, oh, I'm never going to be able to catch up.
我觉得我再也不可能追上那个课程进度。
And how on earth was I supposed to finish my degree?
那么我要怎样完成我的学业呢？
And I thought, God, this is so unfair.
所以我就跟神说啊，这个很不公平。
I didn't do anything. I didn't even jump around.
我根本没有做错事情，我也没有乱跑乱跳。
And for the first time in a long time.
所以那么经历了那么久的时间，我是第一次。
You know, there's a lot of times when you.I feel like I just tell myself, you know, God, I surrender everything into your hands.
因为我很多时候我们会说，神啊，我将我的生命交在你手中。
And then you say it over and over and over until the words sort of lose their meaning.
然后你会很重复讲的这句话，一直到这句话已经根本失去了它本来的意义。
And that's what I found myself doing is just saying words that I didn't mean.
所以在经历这些的事情的时候，我发现到其实我对神说了一些其实我心里根本没有那么想的话语。
And so through this operation and through this experience, I found that for the first time ever, when I said, God, I surrender it into your hands, I actually meant it.
所以这一次当我经历手术的时候，我当我跟神说，神啊，我将我生命交在你手中，我是真正有带着这样的意思跟神说的。
There was nothing that was in my control.
没有东西可以在我掌控之中。
I couldn't control the operation. I couldn't control my flight. I couldn't control my studies.
我的手术，我的学业，甚至我要搭的飞机，完全都不在我掌控之中。
And I felt just so small.
我发现到我是多么的渺小。
And I just found myself placing my life into God's hands.
我只能够把我的生命交在神的手中。
And telling God, you know, here I am.
然后跟神说，神啊，我就在这里。
And just do what you will with my life.
神啊，让我的生命随着你的旨意行走吧。
And so during my rest in hospital.
所以当我在留院休息的时候。
It was probably the only time during my crazy year that I could quieten myself down.
就在去年一整年的繁忙时间当中，我能够安静下来。
And I realized that as I quieted myself down, God began to speak.
我发现当我安静下的时候，神开始对我说话。
So, it was like God was saying there was a lot of pride in my life.
感觉到神对我说，我生命很多的骄傲。
That a lot of times I just want to do things my way.
很多时候我想按照我的方式来做事情。
But I never actually stopped to think and to ask God, God, is this what you want to do in my life?
我根本没有停下来脚步问神，神啊，这是你的旨意吗？
But the thing that amazed me so much.
但是让我感到惊叹的是
was God didn't just stand there and go like, you're such a bad girl.
神没有站在那边来责备我
And like, oh no, look at all you've done. You've messed up everything.
你看看你做了什么，你把事情都搞砸了。
And I'm just going to put you to the side there and you can just cry.
然后我就把你放在一边，然后你就自甘堕落吧。
Instead, he just said, you know, he never just condemned, he never just scolded me. He said, child, my child, this is how I have the best thing that is in my hands, and I just want to guide you. I want to tell you how to live your life the best way.
神没有控告我，没有责备我，反而他说，孩子，我要告诉你那个蒙福、那个得胜的法则。
And I just felt like he was welcoming me back into his arms.
我感觉到他再一次拥抱我，进入他怀抱里面。
And that love is overwhelming.
那个爱是难以形容的。
When I went back to Melbourne,
当我再一次回到墨尔本的时候。
I thought it was going to be chaos.
我觉得我以为回到去是一个会很混乱的状况。
There was a lot of things I couldn't do with my appendicitis. I couldn't carry heavy things. I couldn't walk around too much.
因为手术过后的状况，我其实很多事情不能做，我也不能拿我的行李，我也不可以到处去走。
But I thank God for always looking after me.
但是我感谢神，因为他一直都在看顾着我。
Basically, there were friends, there was church.And every time I felt like I was going to break down from all the pressure, he was there to comfort me.
透过我的朋友，透过当地的教会，透过我朋友，当我觉得我要崩溃的时候，神他都会透过他们来帮助我。
And there was once when I was really, really just, I was really stressed out. I had so much assignments that was waiting for me, and I felt like I couldn't continue anymore.
我记得有一次那个学业的繁忙的功课真的是让我透不过气，我觉得我要崩溃的时候。
And on that same day, I had a discipleship to attend in church.
同一个晚上在教会我又有一个课程，一个门训的课程我需要参加。
And my whole brain was just telling me, no, you should just stay at home and finish your things and or just sleep.
我的理智告诉我，你不用去教会，不需要参加这些课程，只是留在家里把功课给完成，至少你都可以去睡个觉。
But for some reason, there was this tug in my heart that said, you know, just go.
但是在我心中却有一个感动，却在跟我说去呀、啊，去。
So I went with it and I went to church.
所以我就最后去了教会。
And that night, the move of the Spirit was so strong.
那一个晚上，那个圣灵的工作是那么的强烈。
And there was this huge outpouring and waves and waves and waves.
那个圣灵的降临，那个圣灵的那个的充满。
And I just found myself being, it's like somebody was filling me in more and more until I overflowed. That love was so strong, I can't even describe it.
我感觉到那个爱不断的浇灌在我生命里面，直到它满溢出来。我根本很难形容那个爱的感觉是怎样的。
And just like this, the stress, it was just lifted.
就这样，我的压力就慢慢的消失了。
And from all of this, I just learned that sometimes I don't feel like worshiping.
很多时候我感觉到我不想要敬拜。
And I feel like I'm really down. I just want to complain.
我觉得我心情很低落，我只是想抱怨而已。
I don't want to see anyone. I don't want to do anything.
我不想见任何人，我不想做任何的事情。
But I think these are the times when that's the time to just stand up and start to fight.
但是我学习到，就是在这样的状况在这样的状况之下，我必须要站起来来征战，来敬拜。
And I would start to worship, and I would start to declare God's promises.
我就开始来敬拜，开始宣告神的应许。
Sometimes you know you can't find scriptures because you're not that holy, because you can't find, you know, you can't memorize scriptures.
有时候我们不是很圣洁，你知道，你找不到那些适当的经文。
So you know you just Google scriptures.
所以你就会上网去找那些的经文。
Scriptures to praise God.
比如说打赞美神的经文。
And I would just start to declare it and declare it and declare it over my life.
但是找到这些经文，我就不断的来宣告这些经文成就在我生命里面。
And somehow the spiritual atmosphere just begins to change.
就开始的那个属灵环境开始的改变。
And I just found myself being lifted up.
我就感觉到我再一次被建立起来。
So I thank God.So much. I passed my finals with full high distinctions.
So 很感谢神，因为我的年终考试，我得到了很优越的成绩。
I was just as shocked and as everyone else.
我跟其他人都一样，都觉得拿到这样的成绩，我都很惊讶。
And for one of the toughest units that my lecturer, even my lecturer said the unit was a tough unit.
其中一科其实是最难的。
for that unit, he actually wrote a letter to congratulate me on my good results.
而在那一科的那个教那个讲师呢，他就写了一封信来恭贺我。
And I think God has been just so faithful and so true throughout the whole time.
我觉得我这次我真的是可以经历感觉到神是真实并且是信实的。
And it's really when it says it's not by my might or my strength, but the power of God, that scripture just speaks so much.
就是他，正如那个经文所说，不是按照我的能力和我的我的能力和才干，乃是按照神的能力。
And when I was at my lowest valley, His love was there unfailing.
在我的低谷当中的时候，神的爱永远不会离开。
And has turned my valleys into victories.
也将我的低谷转为胜利。
So I know that no matter what the circumstances may look like, no matter how hard the storms may rage,
这次我发现到，无论我的环境多么的艰难，暴风如何的狂烈，
and no matter how impossible the situation looks,
状况看起来是多么的不可能，
but God's promises in my life remain.
神的应许仍然在我生命里面。
And even if I have nothing left and nothing is in my control anymore,
即使没有任何一件事情可以在我掌控里面，
but there is one God who believes in me and there is one God who is there to help me.
但是有一位神在那边帮助我，在那边来等待我。
I just want to give all glory to God.
所以我要将一切荣耀归给我们的神。
Thank you.
谢谢。